وين الضربة طيب؟
اهدى لي
What we know is that at least 17,000 children are estimated to be unaccompanied or separated from surviving family members, and at least 4,000 children are likely to be buried under the rubble. Children have made up about 40% of all deaths in Gaza. And so if we follow that logic, and we know that at least 10,000 people are buried under the rubble, we can calculate that at least 4,000 children are also likely buried under the rubble. At this point, presumed dead. We know also that an unknown number of children have been detained by Israeli forces, have been forcibly transferred out of Gaza, and are buried in unmarked graves. You know, there was a time period where we were seeing mass graves found. Several mass graves have been found, and an unknown number of the bodies that were found in the mass graves have been children. It has been incredibly difficult to verify the identity of children who have been killed in Gaza, as well as those found in mass graves, because they're bodies have been harmed beyond recognition. And because so many children have had their families completely wiped out, have lost all next of kin, that's an added obstacle in identifying their identity, their names, and the families that they belong to. We know that from parents that some kids are so traumatized that even when there is food, they are unable to eat. We know, you know, from our, we are providing pediatric services in field hospitals in Gaza, and we've heard that some children are so malnourished that they don't even have the energy to cry. I mean, the toll that this war will have on children in Gaza will span generations. It will impact them physically and mentally.